gentlemen, we're delighted to have you participate in the first annual 2012 SBC Drama Festival. Thank you for coming. First of all, I must ask you to please turn your phones on silent, to avoid taking flash photography, and to remain in your seats during the show, because this distracts the actors. There will be three short plays, each about 15 minutes long. There will be no intermission. This means that when one play ends, the other will start immediately. Once the show is over, there will be a question and answer session with the actors. In the Q&A session, you can ask them anything you like, be it about the play, their interpretations, or anything. The theme of these three plays are how we change ourselves to be closer to other people, and the changes that we make in our own lives to bring us closer to the lives of others, and to bring us closer to love, without which nothing much gets done in this world. The first play is called The Sure Thing by David Ives, a New York playwright. This play takes place in a coffee shop and is about a boy and a girl meeting. It's about how we often wish we could take back the last thing we said, because maybe if we'd said something different, our whole lives would have been different. In this play, fate, in the form of a bell, lets the actors do just that. The second play will be the balcony scene, Act 2, Scene 2, from Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet. This is a scene where Romeo and Juliet admit their feelings for one another and their willingness to leave behind the traditional values of their families to pursue what they believe to be right in their hearts. Creative alterations have been made to this play to express the idea that people sometimes have more than one feeling about the decisions they make, as in the case of Juliet. The third play is called English Made Simple, also by David Ives. This is about a boy and a girl meeting at a party, and how we may say one thing, yet mean another. It's about how people who are made for one another can see through the boundaries of language and to what lies beneath, the truth, unexpressed, and how, when we find the right person, words are no longer really necessary. These plays feature comedy elements, so feel free to laugh. Thank you for coming.
Excuse me, is this chair leaving?
No, but I'm expecting somebody very shortly.
Would you mind if I sit here till he or she or it comes?
Well, they do seem to be pretty late.
You never know who you may be turning down.
Sorry, nice try though.
Sure thing. Is this seat taken?
No, it's not.
Would you mind if I sit here?
Yes, I would.
Oh. Is this chair taken?
No, it's not.
Would you mind if I sit here?
No, go ahead.
Oh, thanks. Every place else seems to be taken.
Mm-hmm.
Great place for reading.
I just want to read in quiet, if you mind.
Okay, sure thing. Every place else seems to be taken.
Mm-hmm.
Great place for reading.
Yes, I like it.
Hey, what's a book?
The Sound and the Hero.
Oh, Hemingway! What's a book?
The Sound and the Fury.
Oh, Faulkner!
Have you read it?
Not actually. I have a dream about it soon. It's supposed to be great.
It is great.
I heard it's great. Waiter! What's a book?
The Sound and the Fury.
Oh, Faulkner!
Have you read it?
Yeah, I'm a baseball fan myself.
Have you read it?
I read it in college.
What was college?
I went to SBC.
What was college?
I was lying. I never really went to college. I just like to party.
What was college?
Harvard.
Do you like Faulkner?
Yeah, I love Faulkner. I spent the whole winter reading him once.
I have just started.
I was so excited after 10 pages, and I went out for everything else I wrote. One of the greatest reading experiences of my life. I mean, all of that incredible psychological understanding. The page after page of the beautiful prose, and the profound grasp of the mystery of time and the human existence. The smells of the earth. What do you think?
I think it's pretty boring.
Hey, what's the book?
The Sound and the Fury.
Oh, Faulkner.
Do you like Faulkner?
Yeah, I love Faulkner.
He is incredible.
I spent the whole winter reading once.
I was so excited after 10 pages that I went on about everything else he wrote.
How is that incredible psychological understanding?
And the prose is so gorgeous.
And ways to grasp the mystery of time.
And human existence. I can't believe I'm waiting this long to read him.
Yeah, you never know. You may not have been like him before.
That's true.
You may not have been reading for him. You have to miss these things and let him know as far as he knew.
Yes,
it's
happened to me.
It's all in the timing. My name's Bill, by the way.
I'm Betty.
Hi.
Hi.
I thought reading Faulkner was a great reading experience.
Yes.
The Sound and the Fury.
Well, onwards and upwards.
Wheeler? You have to hit these things and read them all those parts look good.
That's happened to me.
It's all the timing. My name's Bill, by the way.
I'm Betty.
Hi. So, do you come here a lot?
Actually, I'm just in town for 2 days. From Pakistan.
Oh, Pakistan. My name's Bill, by the way.
I'm Betty.
Hi.
Hi.
Do you come here a lot?
Every once in a while, do you?
Not so much anymore, not as much as I used to before my nervous breakdown. Do you come here a lot?
Why are you asking?
I'm just interested.
Are you really interested? Or do you just want to pick me up?
No, I'm really interested.
Why would you be interested in when I come here a lot?
I'm just getting acquainted.
Maybe you are only interested for the sake of making small talk long enough to ask me back to your place to listen to some music. Or because you have bought some great DVD. Or because you have got some terrific Eastern CDs. Only all you want to do is fool around, which you wish you very well. After which, you are going to the bathroom and keep very loudly, and then head into the kitchen and get yourself a beer from the refrigerator without asking me whether I like anything. And then you proceed to lie back down beside me and confess that you've got a girlfriend and stabbing me with a way I've met with me in Belgium for a year and that you have been following her up and up for the past 7 years. Now that which interests me, mister.
Do you come here a lot?
Every other day, I think.
I come here quite a lot, and I don't remember seeing you.
I guess you must be on different schedules.
Yeah, miss the connection.
Yes, different time zones.
Amazing how you can live right next door to somebody in this town and never even know it.
I know.
City life.
It's crazy.
We probably pass each other in the street every day in front of this place, probably.
Yeah.
Well, the greatest here sure seem to be in some different time zone. I can't seem to look it right anywhere. So, where? So what do you?
Back pardon?
Nothing, sorry.
I I guess we must be on different schedules.
Mr. Connection?
Yes, different time zones.
Amazing! How can you thread like straw with somebody in this town and never even know it?
I know.
City life.
It's crazy.
So, you were waiting for somebody like me, were you?
Actually, I was.
Oh, boyfriend?
Sort of.
What's a sort of boyfriend?
My husband.
You were waiting for somebody like me, were you?
Sort of.
What's a sort of boyfriend?
We were meeting here to break up.
What's a sort of boyfriend?
My lover. Here she comes right now.
You were reading for somebody like Kimin, were you?
No, just reading.
Sort of set occupation for Friday night, isn't it?
Do you think so?
Reading here all by yourself.
Trying to keep away from lines like that.
No, listen. You were waiting for somebody, right, Kimin, were you?
No, just reading.
Sort of set occupation for Friday night, isn't it? Reading here all by yourself.
I guess it is, in a way.
What's a good looking like you doing out alone on Friday night anyway? No offense, but...
I'm out alone on Friday night for the first time in a very long time.
Oh.
You see, I just recently ended a relationship.
Oh.
Of rather long stay.
Hey, come back, I'm sorry. Since reading here is such side occupation for Friday night, so would you want to go out as well?
No.
Do something else?
No, thanks.
I was headed out to the movies in your world anyway.
I don't think so.
Big chance Black Falcon cut his breath. All those long sentences got him pretty tired.
Thanks anyway.
Okay.
I appreciate the invitation.
Sure thing. You were waiting for somebody, right, Kimmy, for you?
No, just reading.
Sort of set occupation for Friday night. Reading here all by yourself?
I guess it is. I guess I'm trying to think about it as existentially romantic. You know, cappuccino, great literature, reading night.
That's only working in Paris. We could have the late band in Paris. Get a canker, then the caffeine.
I'm a little short of pleasure tonight.
Sorry, so am I.
To tell you the truth, I was headed to the movies after finishing this section. Would you like to come along, since you can't get a waiter?
That's a very nice offer, but...
girlfriend?
Two, actually. One of them is pregnant and stabbed me.
Girlfriend?
No, I don't have a girlfriend. Not if you mean the bitch I dumped last night.
Girlfriend?
Sort of.
What is a sort of girlfriend?
My mother.
Oh.
I just ended a relationship, actually.
Oh.
Of rather long standing.
I'm sorry to tell that.
It's my first night doing all alone in a long time. I feel a little bit insane, to tell the truth.
So you didn't stop to talk because you're a salesman? Or you have some weird political beliefs?
Nope. Straight down taken Republic. Straight down taken Demo. Hey, can I tell you something about the politics? I like to think of myself as a citizen of the universe. I don't care about the politics.
Oh, that's really neither do I.
Yeah, I've bought my beliefs.
Labels are not important.
Labels are not important, exactly. Take me, for example. I mean, what does it matter if I had a 2.0, 3.0, 4.0 in college? So, if I did come from the countryside, a small town, Shanghai?
Sure!
I believe that man is what he is. A person is what he is. A person is what they are.
I think so too.
So what if I admire Fengjie? So what if I lose weight 400 pounds? So what if I don't have any clothes? So what if I spend a year in Peace Corps? I was acting on my beliefs.
Sure.
You just can't hurt a certain person.
Absolutely. I don't want your skull here. Listen, I was headed to the movies after I finished this section. Would you like to come along?
That sounds like fun. What's the plan?
A couple of the really early Woody Allen movies.
Oh.
You don't like Woody Allen?
Sure, I like Woody Allen.
But you're not crazy about Woody Allen.
Those early ones kind of got on my nerves.
I was thinking about...
I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
I was going to say that I was headed up to movies in a little while and...
So was I.
The Woody Allen Festival?
Just up the street.
Do you like the early ones?
I think anybody who doesn't have to be wrong on the planet.
So how many times have you seen Bananas?
8 times.
Oh, So, I was still interested.
And do you like birthday cake?
Last night, I went out at 2 in the morning to get one. So, did you have a Barbie doll as a child?
Yes, and do you like broccoli?
No, I think it's disgusting.
It is disgusting.
So, do you still believe in marriage is the love of caring, sentiment against it?
Yes.
And children?
3 of them.
2 girls and a boy.
Hubbard, Vester, and Brown.
And will you love me?
Yes.
And cherish me forever?
Yes.
Do you still want to go to the movies?
Sure thing.
Wait. So, one last room, the window breaks. It is the east. And Julia is the song. A rise their song. And the cute envious moon, who is already sick and pale with grief. Says all the maid are far more fair than she. Be not her maid. See she is envious. The vast delivery is but sick and green. And now the wood wear it. Cast it off. My lady, oh, it's my love. Such a nurse you are. She's weak, yet she's a nasty thing. What of that? Her eyes discourse unanswered. I'm too bold. It's not to me she's doing. Two of the fairest stars in all the heaven. Heaven's a business. To enter in her eyes, to drink her mysterious till they reach her. What if her eyes were serious in her head? Brightness of her cheek will shame those stars. As daylight those are lamp. Her eyes in heaven will through the airy region so bright. And the bird will sing, and sing it for no night. See how she lay her cheek upon her head. That I might be a blood upon her head. That I might touch that cheek.
I am maid.
She speaks. Oh, speak again, bright angel. For the art is glorious through this night. Woman, my face. As we messenger unto the white altering eyes of mortal, the flock back to gaze on him, when he rides a lazy, lazy cloud. The cells upon the poison of the air.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo, wilful adored Romeo, deny.
Should I hear more? Or should I dig at it?
Do not swear at all. Or if you will, swear by the wish yourself. Wish the God Almighty astrology. And I will believe you.
In my heart's dear love.
Do not swear. Although I join you. I have no joy of this contract tonight. It is too rash, too sudden, too unadvised, too enlightening. What is this to do? As soon as one can say, it enlightens. Sweet, good night. Is this not the love by summer's regrets? We could have been to flower when night we meet. Good night. Thanks to me, we have hope and rest. Comfort of our heart, and that with my rest.
Oh, well, you made me so unsatisfied.
What satisfaction can you have tonight?
To exchange of your love face of all for mine.
I gave you mine before you did request it. And yet I wish I could give it again.
Would you withdraw from what purpose, love?
But to be frank, I give to you again. Yet I wish for the things I have. My bounty is as boundless as the sea, my love as deep. The more I gave it to you, the more I have. For the rose, I keep feminine.
Juliet!
I heard a noise within. Sweet love, a tear, and my goodness! Sweet love you, did you stay? But a little, I'll come up again.
Last night, I'm afraid to be night. All this is but a dream. Too false and sweet, too substantial.
Romeo?
No. My dear?
Shall I for you?
It's the hour of nine.
I will not fail. It's 20 years till then. I forgot why I call you back.
Let me stay here until you remember it.
I should have forgot. Two hands to stand there, remembering how I love your company.
And I will still stand to have you still forget, forgetting any other home but this.
Good night. Pass me a sweet sorrow, and I should say good night till it be morrow.
In front of us, full of joy.
Hello.
And then goodbye.
Section 2, the structure of English conversation. Fred, first name.
Mary,
first name.
Hello.
Salutation. Social display of affection, followed by, I didn't know you were here. Friendly observation, answered by,
I'm here.
Statement of the obvious, how are you? Superficial question about health.
Good.
Superficial answer, occupational question.
How's the job?
And,
terrific.
Acceptable horse food. What's a buffet?
Well,
add a new topic.
Well.
Now coming to noise, reject topic and...
I was in love with you once upon a time.
You asked me about my job and lied to you.
You who look so self-possessed and mature.
I would have answered you honestly once upon a time.
Once upon a time, you cried on my shoulder like a little child.
We would have talked like two people who love each other. Then we would have gone home.
We used to go to parties like this all the time.
Together.
So happy. Wow.
Nice seeing you, Fred.
Expression of pleasure. First name.
Take care of yourself, Mary.
Parting wish. First name.
Bye.
Validation. Section 3. Simultaneous translation, or the secret meanings of common English words.
Well, well, well.
Oh, shit.
I didn't know you were here.
What are you doing here?
How are your head?
Wasn't 5 years enough?
I'm good.
Get lost, Angus.
Nice party.
Well, very nice.
Get lost, Angus.
So, what are you doing with yourself?
Are you still sleeping with that slut from the community college?
Same old thing.
It's not a good damn business.
Have you tried it, chicken?
I hope you'll get sick.
No, I'm sticking with liquids.
I know you have problems with mother, but you don't have to poison me.
See you, Hank.
I'm yours.
Take care.
Get lost, Agnes.
Bye.
Section 7. Fill in the blank.
Excuse me, but do I know you? My name is Jack.
Hi.
My name is Antonio.
How are you?
My name is Trev.
How do you do?
Melvin, and you are
Jill.
Hi, Jill.
Monica.
How are you, Monica?
Monica. What's his name?
Dennis.
Should we have gone to college together?
I went to Fudan.
Oh.
Tongji. SBC.
And I'm sorry, your name is?
Louis, and you are?
Barney.
Where did you grow up, Bob?
Where?
Jim?
Well.
Sally?
Well, I grew up in Guangzhou.
Oh.
Hangzhou.
Great place.
Shanghai.
Nice!
What about you, Jane?
My name is Jill!
Oh, I'm sorry, Jill.
And yet really, my name could be anything.
Anyway, I went to medical school.
I wasn't born with a name.
Went to law school.
I was given a name.
Went to plumbing school.
My name could be just as easily Beth or Phyllis or Jane.
Quite a buffet, isn't it?
Or Gertrude or Natasha.
Do you know what the trouble with the buffet is? There are too many choices.
A hummingbird doesn't have a name.
Do I want the chicken or the roast beef?
A fish doesn't have a name.
Cheese or a pate?
A hedgehog doesn't have a name.
It's just like life that way.
It's just this nameless thing. Handful of skin and fur and heartbeat inside it.
Should I walk? Should I read? Should I listen to the music?
Completely anonymous.
Should I come to this party or should I go to the movies?
A hedgehog doesn't even know it doesn't have a name.
Sometimes there are so many choices. I don't do anything.
With a name, you're just an example of something.
I thought to myself, This party could be a total waste.
But I'm not an example of something.
But I came to this party because I thought I might meet the love of my life.
I am somebody.
Do you think she's you?
I'm Jill.
I'm Jack.
Hello.
Section 26, the conditional tense, or should, could, would.
Okay, so we meet at this party.
And we like each other.
And we like each other instantly. I'm Sino.
Miranda, did you know that the first 3 minutes of a conversation can determine your relationship to the other person for all eternity?
But we pass the 3 minutes mark. We meet and we match.
What a match!
And it all begins right here on this spot. In a single moment, all things seem possible.
All things are possible.
The infinite buffet lies before us, but what do?
The path is running up.
The crowd is thinning.
But the question of the moment is,
do I ask you out?
Do I ask you out?
And if you do,
should I accept?
This could be one of those glorious and intoxicating meetings best left in memory.
Or it might be the start for eternal love.
So I say, would you like to get a cup of coffee sometime? And you say,
sorry for sense anyway. Bye.
And that's where, no thank you.
A dead end.
But possibly a happy dead end. Well, down this road here is,
would you like to get a cup of coffee sometime?
Sure.
So we go out for coffee.
And we had a horrible time.
Dead end.
Or a wonderful time, in which case,
we get a second cup.
And stop right here.
Dead end.
Or we go out for a third cup, a fourth cup, and a fifth cup.
We have made love by now.
Maybe we would have.
I say we should have.
You certainly could have.
Let's say we did.
And it was horrible. Dead end.
Or it was wonderful, in which means
more coffee and
we move in with each other.
Oh, mistake.
Dead end.
Or it was wonderful.
And so we get engaged.
Marriage,
children, boys, and also divorce.
Or the other road. Maybe we are down the road of no thank you we took years and years ago, and years pass.
And we meet each other at a party and you say,
hello, I'm Zena.
Miranda.
Don't I know you from somewhere?
And the whole universe opens up in front of us.
Full of joy.
All things are possible.
And it starts right on this spot.
Dead end.
Or bliss.
Should, would, could.
Well, it was nice meeting you, Miranda.
Yes, nice meeting you, Zena.
Section 78, saying goodbye.
Listen, I only have a few minutes.
Let's practice a typical interchange.
The crowd is thinning and the party's wrapping up. Coats are disappearing from the pile on the back.
A typical interchange, please.
I just wanted to say while I have a chance that you are the most wonderful woman at this party.
Typical, please.
On this street, in the city, in this country, on this planet.
You're the most wonderful man I've met in years.
You have a light that surrounds you.
You are intoxicating.
You are radiant. I came to this party one day, and I leave it transformed.
I came to this party to meet the love of my life.
And you are her.
You are she.
You are her. You are the love of my life.
My name could be anything.
But it's Jill.
I could have gone anywhere tonight.
But you came to this party.
Hello, hello.
Abracadabra. My name is Jack.
Would you like to get a cup of coffee sometime, Jack?
Yes, Jill. I would like that very much.
And it all happens right here.
A plus.
Thank you for coming and for supporting SBC and the SBC Arts and Drama Society. You now have the choice to either stay for the question and answer session or to leave. If you wish to stay, please think of questions in advance and who you'd like to ask. If you wish to leave, you may do so now. Thank you.
My question is, how did you decide on which three plays to choose? Because presumably you had looked at other plays as well. Was this something that you, for example, you've chosen two plays by David Ives, was that a writer, an artist that you enjoy particularly? Or how did you come to choose the three plays that you chose?
I chose the plays.
Oh, okay. Then my next question is, I'm assuming you'd all heard of Romeo and Juliet before, but had you heard of the other two plays before you decided to?
Actually, my partner and I once had a deep, in-depth view of the play. So I actually went on the internet and searched the play, English Museum, on the internet. And I found out it was first acted in 1994 in a theater, I forgot the name, and we have some knowledge about it. But actually, our director, David Warner, chose the three plays, and we just try our best to act.
Well, it was excellent. They were all excellent, so thank you very much for that. I'll pass another question. This is a technical question. I'm very curious about why you chose to stage the section of Romeo and Juliet the way you did. Could you answer that? Why did you choose that particular dramatic format? It's extremely unusual, of course.
Let me
know
its answer.
Sorry for crushing
it. It's very unusual to stage the way you did. Of course, having Romeo on this set, but to have two Juliets speaking in tandem, this is very unusual. And how did you choose, what was your rationale for presenting it this way?
At first, the place, we stand here and we have two stages here in the back because it's shows on the balcony. But unfortunately, we didn't have a balcony here, so we just put Juliet up the aside behind the audience. Because we have two Juliets, because our director believes that the Juliet is the innocent and the sweet girl, but inside of her, it's two persons. Some big part of her want to go to his Romeo, and she just wants to follow him, and another one just very shy and afraid to speak out what she wants, so we have two Juliets. And I'm the, the more natural one, and she's the innocent one. So that's why at the end I worked out and to follow the Romeo.
Thank
you for the question.
Firstly, well done for all the performance. And I will still remember in play one, and Elaine